This is the Edge for GameEdged. Thank you for joining me. And we're here with Cage848 from, well, he's got Twitch, but he's also got an amazing YouTube channel. Check him out. I've been able to talk about him over and over, guys. And if you see, haven't seen the first episode, you should go and check it out. Check it out from both a point of view. You get to see Cage's, where he's working his ass off building all this stuff. And I was taking my lazy ass building that little thing over there. How you doing, Cage?
What's up, man? Jeez, that thing's freaking ginormous.
Isn't it?
Is that going to take, like, all the logs in the forest?
Exactly. We're gonna build this baby up. We're gonna see how high we can go. I think we're gonna try and build a big tower this time. I don't think everybody's ever done that. See if we can how high we can go here.
Here, follow me.
All right, I'm going with you. You're like a special axe somewhere.
No. You'll see.
Coming.
This is coming. I just have to find a good cluster of trees.
Ooh. You
okay?
Yeah, no, it's because flowers. As soon as I see flowers, you live in a, well, I live in a forest area on a solo, and, you know, I see flowers and I get all, like, flustered. I'm still picking them up. It's like rocks.
Well, that's good. That's good. Because I'm not picking up any.
It's like a dog with a squirrel. Look, flower.
I wonder if they, like, messed around with the position of trees, because there used to be big clusters of trees here. Now there's, like, they're kind of all spread out a little bit.
Yeah, you're kind of right.
Right?
And sticky bombs would help you. This here, this area used to be a whole bunch. You just hit this, and it'll be like five or six of them coming down.
Hmm. Oh, this isn't bad, I guess.
There's one right here, yeah.
You got one?
Oh, no. Go. I want to see it. Go ahead. Oh, that's a nice one right here. Yeah, that's much better. Get rid of these bushes so I can see
it. I almost forgot to light it. I always do that. Fire in the hole!
Oh, shit! Oh shit! Get the fuck out of the way! Get the fuck! It's gonna kill me!
That was a lot bigger than I thought.
Wow, brother, you took out a whole lot of trees. Oh shit.
Welcome to deforest!
Fucking Christ, that's amazing. Alright, let's get this in here. Was it 196 logs?
We got half that.
Yeah, okay. We got half that with that one explosion. Where's that sweet spot? Oh man.
Oh no.
They gotta fix that. Come on.
It's gotta be over here? No, really?
Right here. Right over here. Yeah, it's stupid. I mean, if it's the outlines here, we should be.
That's gotten worse. Everywhere. Like, that didn't used to be that bad.
No. I don't think I've built a big platform like this in there.
No, I have. I've never had that like that before.
Really? I wonder if they're tinkering with their load too much.
Yeah, in a bad way.
Yeah.
It's like ShopKeep. Like, they just did nothing on ShopKeep, and they kind of messed up a couple things with it, but, you know.
It's a great game. I love watching you play that. That's actually a really good game.
It's a lot of fun.
Yeah. I don't think I could do as good of a job as you could. I actually got the game, and I stood there and went, yeah, not me. No, can't do it. I can watch people do it. I love watching it, you know?
Well, it sounds more like you don't enjoy it that much. Maybe like
watching some games.
Yeah, maybe like watching it more. Yeah, I'm like that with some other games.
Sometimes it's just more fun to sit there and watch other people go through that process, because it seems like a lot of work.
No, not at all. I love it. Now, the problem with TNT mining is... Now we have a problem of we have no sap because we didn't cut down the trees like we should have.
Yeah, how much sap do we have here? None.
I have zero.
Yeah.
I think as soon as it's daytime, we're gonna go get the sap collector thingies.
Really extend time like 7 days to die. That'd be awesome.
What's that?
Make more daylight time. I mean, this nighttime is cool, but for the building part, it'd be nice if we could actually alter that.
I really enjoy the nighttime in this game. I really do. The people in my Let's Play, watching my Let's Play, are not fans, though. It's too dark for them, and they don't really get into it that much. It's not so scary for them watching.
Oh, this is uber scary, honestly.
As it is for... Well, it's more when you're playing, you know?
Yeah. Okay, let's go get a seat here. 1 second, our guy is a little bit tired. Make me run around. We're bringing log sleds. I don't know why we didn't use our log sleds for this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's close. That's why I like... That's
there's
why I like
a lot
building
of logs
here.
Left.
Is there? I don't see any.
Yeah, there's a whole bunch of log sleds. We dumped them all in there.
Oh, I thought you meant logs. Yeah.
Oh, no. No.
I don't see any more logs.
I'm getting cold.
Well, you're not spooning with me again. last time you got a little frisky, so no. You're on your own.
Yeah, you asked for it.
So my wife is, you know, the typical female. She gets cold. Mm-hmm. You know, she's always cold.
Yeah.
She comes home the other day. It was like 38 degrees out, like raining. Like if it was any colder, it would be snowing. And she comes home and she is an ice cube. So she puts her legs on my back, and you know, and I'm like, you gotta be kidding me. Like, you gotta be joking.
And you're stuck there going, okay, yep, honey, I'm
like,
love you.
And like, I don't like mine like cold because I'm always hot, but like, it's just that frozen like leg. It's just like, oh my god.
Yeah, that's too much in the back. That's way too much.
Yeah, I mean, I started seeing icicles around my field of view, just like in this game.
So I'm just going, you know what? Hawaiian pizza, and he gets your back. There you go. Fucking Christ.
Oh,
you
goodness.
Don't realize that Cage, again, if Cage has its own channel, you guys have visited. I know a lot of my viewers watch your stuff too, so, I mean, it's normal, but Cage has this thing with deers.
I hate them.
Watch his videos. He has them.
You mean about. Hold on. You know who I hate more than deers? Cannibals.
Oh, this one here. Oh. Who's looking at you? This is a nice diversion. I like that.
It's like, that's like pro strats, guys. Anyone watching this video should write that down. Get your friend to distract the cannibal.
Can't pick her up. It's a weird thing. They have a lot of work to do. There you go.
Just burn!
Burn, bitch. It's like being an Ozzy Osbourne concert. This is awesome. All right, let's rock this here. So many flowers. All right, let's get this. Only one female that showed up, that's it? That's unusual.
Yeah, like, we're getting attacked a lot, but they're not coming in, like, all together.
Yeah, that's strange. That's really strange. But if you're wondering now, we're building this big, massive base here, and we're actually going to put the stairs straight out towards... Well, we're supposed to put the stairs out here, I guess. And hopefully we're going to build as high as we possibly can. And build
you're the foreman. Tower. You're the foreman on this.
Well, yeah. We'll do some building together. You picked a awesome spot. This actually... One spot we've done it way back a few seasons ago on Fort Grizzly.
Yeah, this really is awesome. Like the best spot to build.
Yeah, you picked a good one. I'd be okay with this. It's a lot of work, a lot of grinding to do, but we could do this.
So I guess they already watched episode one, so let's ask the big question. How's your frame rate?
My frame rates are a whole lot better.
Okay.
Thank you to Cage, because yeah, we actually went through his little... his processes and how he actually has settings, and it makes a lot more sense, so unfortunately.
Yeah, the forest is very strange with me. Hold on. We got some action here.
Where is she? Oh, she's a hungry one. Oh, you're right in the face. That's nice. Man, talk about getting hoarse. That's awesome. Oh, last shot.
She got destroyed.
Oh my god, these girls. I get like people telling me there shouldn't be nudity in this game, but you know, that's part of the problem.
Yeah, yeah. It's like weird though. It's not like graphic nudity. It's like you really have to look for it, you know? Like it's not
if that
like,
turns you on.
Is yeah, if that's what does it for you, then it's got it. And if it doesn't do it for you, then you just ignore it. Yeah. You know, it's not like in your face, I don't think.
Like National Geographic style, you know? He's not gonna be sitting down and watching this going, No, Mom, give me 5 more minutes of the stock, I'm fine. It's just, you know, it's a part of the game, it's part of nature, and that's what the guys... But they started wearing clothes and shit, it wouldn't make much sense. They really wouldn't. Then again, they have a lot of cloth, they're pretty stupid, but...
Well, they cover up the junk downstairs.
Yeah.
But here's the thing, though. Like, Russ doesn't care. Like, they show the whatever, you know?
Oh, yeah, they do?
Russ shows the schlongs, like, just flying out there, like... Yeah,
I did see that before.
It's crazy.
That's right.
And the thing is, it doesn't make any sense. You're not a newborn baby. You would have clothes, you know? You didn't just fall out of the sky naked. Like, that doesn't make any sense. So no,
for sure.
That's just for shock value. I never liked that about Rust.
Rust is, yeah, PvE, right, isn't it?
PvP.
PvP? Okay.
Yeah.
I see a bit of it. I just didn't fall interested to it. I think I see a couple of videos of it. Did you used to play that game?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I played it for a while.
Yeah.
I played it before they had sleepers. See... When, like, before they had sleepers, it was fun because you could, like, you know, you could put a couple things on your guy, so if your base gets raided, you still have something left. Okay. But then they started putting sleepers, and then basically, you know, like, little Joey Bob Timbo is gonna, like, come in your base because he plays 24/7. He was gathering C4 for the entire day because he doesn't have a job, he doesn't have school because it's the middle of the summer. And he comes in and he kills you and he takes all your stuff. And the worst part about it is it's not even stuff he needs, he's just doing it to be a dick. So,
that's not fair.
You know, like, a very, like, it was not a good experience. I mean, it was fun in the beginning, but once, you know, the thing is you really have to dedicate yourself, and if you can't play every day, you shouldn't bother playing at all.
No, that's a hardcore nonstop playing, and then if the guys are stealing your shit too, I don't know, that's not cool.
Oh yeah, yeah, I mean, like, you know, they just come in and they kill me because I'm sleeping, because I'm at work, you know, because I actually have to work.
Oh, yeah, Jesus. You have to work for them.
You know, I gotta work. Shit. And I have a wife, and, you know, like, I like to play other games too. I'm not just gonna just play Rust. I mean, it's a good game, but I'm not just gonna play Rust.
Yeah, and 7 Days to Die is way better.
Oh, 7 Days to Die is the bomb. And they got that new Rust type game, Subsistence. Kind of reminds me a little bit of Rust. Somebody took exception that I referred to it as, like, you know, kind of like Rust, but it kind of like is like Rust. But they've also, like, the developers got PvE and co-op in mind. You know, it's not just going to be you know, PvP. So
no, he's got his own ideas and stuff. But it wasn't like he invented a new style of game. Most of the stuff stolen, like, from Minecraft. And that's the way it goes, you know. Crafting a lot started there, and no one's really invented the wheel here, so it makes sense. Rust, if it's just like that, then yeah.
I really liked Rust, and if I was, like, you know, if I was 15, I'd probably be on it every day. Like, you know, when I was a kid, it would be right up my alley. It's just not, it doesn't work as well for adults, because we gotta do, like, real life stuff. Like tomorrow, I gotta spend most of the day doing my taxes, you know?
Oh, that's fun.
Yeah, so...
Yeah, you're right. Up there. So
I gotta give 35% to Uncle Sam.
35%?
Yeah. It's called, like, they just, like, the tax people just make up, like, taxes. It's criminal. They're basically thieves. And because of the government, there's nothing we can do about it. When I, like, you know, started making money on YouTube, I had to start, you know, filing, you know, for, like, I owe now. And they have this thing where it's called self-employment tax. So, okay, what the hell does that even mean? Like, that's just, we're going to tax you because we want to. And the self-employment tax is 15%.
Damn. Okay, that's not cool at all. Oh, shit. Damn, boy.
I got messed up. I don't have any healing items either. We should probably go looting.
Some good stuff. We need some good stuff here. Oh, lizard.
We're just piling bodies.
Holy shit. At least the bones are coming out pretty nice. That's good. Where's the little bone thing? Oh, it's full? Shit.
Man, we got really gotta...
For a long time.
We really gotta get the sap collector things going.
Yeah, you know what? That's what we're gonna do now. You're right. Let's get that going, because we're not gonna make anything without that shit.
4, 5, 6.
We gotta pick trees, though. Which trees are we not gonna blow up?
I'm making bone armor, so, the bone thing is not full anymore.
Hey, we're gonna keep one tree here at least. I'll put this one.
I mean, it's not like that big of a deal, because we could always put it on a tree far away, you know, but it doesn't have to be right next to us.
Yeah, we'll put one now. Oh, wait a second. I need a pot.
I know where there's one. Close. We just gotta wait for daytime.
Does it work for this one? What the fuck? Right.
By the way, guys, bone armor is the greatest thing ever invented in this game so far.
Yeah.
So, that just shit saying. Awesome. Just saying.
He's hardcore on that shit. Oh, there we go. This tree works.
Well, we never got that episode because you had FPS issues. So, I'll explain it again. The reason I love bone armor is because I think it adds a great degree of balance to the world. Because, you know, you have to go hunting mutants. Like, there's no reason to ever hunt mutants, and now we have a reason. And it's a risk-reward, you know? A lot of times, you know, you might get hurt, and it might not be a good idea, but... You know, sometimes you just have to do it. And the bone armor's freaking insane.
It's really freaking nice, isn't it? You go up to 200, right? I think it's 200%.
Yeah, not only is it it's nice armor, but it's twice as strong as the lizard armor. I mean, like, good. In my one video, I was wearing it, and I had a mutant beating on me, and he barely touched me. No, he didn't barely touch me. He touched me, but no, it wasn't that big of a deal.
He just touched me in different ways.
Yeah, he touched me, and I reported him to the police, and, you know, he won't be around much anymore.
Oh, shit. But you know what? It's quite interesting. I'm happy the guys did it. I mean, just as long as they keep... I think they need to adjust a couple of things with the game, for sure, with the bone armor, too, but then they can add a little more to it. But, I mean, it looks nice, but I don't understand a cloth how it changed to white. There's a couple of things I just don't get, but it's okay.
The log, the log sled edition was the big one, man. Like they went from what, like 7 to 11 logs.
Yeah, that was,
and they
that
added
was
flags on them. I mean, genius.
Yeah, these guys are starting to move their way through this. I'm happy to see the game grow again. Like we said before, I hope it doesn't go out of alpha. I want to keep it going a bit. I just don't find, I think they could do so much with this game. As long as the sales are good anyways on Steam, it doesn't make a difference. Whoa!
Sorry. There you go.
I was looking for another log.
I was like, oh, I hope that doesn't kill him.
But it would make for a good video.
Dude, I can add to that. I can add to that structure from here. From, you see where what? I'm standing? I can add to it
oh,
from
shit.
Here.
Shit. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
Why is that?
Because multiplayer's buggy.
Are we building underneath? I don't know what.
No, I don't think so.
Okay, that's free. Need a pot for that. Tap.
All right, let's go get the pot. Follow me to victory!
We're going for the pot. We're going for the pot.
Oop. Yep.
I'm surfing. 1 second. Oop, there we go. I was stuck. I glitched out onto the log sled there, and I was like surfing across. All right, we're good. We're good.
You know what? On the way to the pot, let's hit this thing. Keep an eye out for turtles, too.
They should be kind of short right now. This is the time of the day they usually pop up, don't they?
I don't. I'm the worst turtle finder ever. Like when I first started looking for turtles, people were yelling at me. I did a whole video where I looked for turtles and I kept running by them, and like people in the comments were just going ape shit.
So, oh really?
Yeah.
You're walking past them.
Yep. I should do it on purpose next time. I've thought of like making YouTube series where I just troll people and not say anything. Like I used to play a game called RimWorld.
Yeah.
And people were always mad that like, you know, I didn't do things right. So like I was thinking I should make one where I just do everything wrong on purpose, but completely play it off like I'm not doing it on purpose. And I could drive people nuts. I really could.
That'd be an excellent idea if you think about it.
Yeah.
This would be one of those things where you actually turn around and you actually just sit there. I don't see a turtle.
Yeah.
What turtle are you talking about?
Yeah, nope, like I wouldn't be able to do too much of it in this game, but RimWorld would be a great one to do it. And I could be like, oh, I put this here, and then like I know how to piss people off because I've done it by accident in the past. And like, but I know how to do it now. I could just be like, you know, oh, I got this base set up. Why isn't he going there? Come on, man. And then I could be like, come on, developers, fix your game with broken shit. You know, like just go, like I could really piss people off. They don't, if they don't catch on, you know.
No, well, it would be a good little series.
It would be pretty funny. It would be pretty friggin' funny.
I'm sure you get a couple of them following you going, he's just an idiot. Follow this guy. He's a fucking idiot, man.
This guy sucks. I hate you. I hate you, KJ48.
Turtles all over the place.
Where?
Right here.
Where?
Right here.
I don't see any turtles. Fuck you, man. You're lying. Stop lying to me.
Look, I'm hitting one right now.
All right, it wouldn't work so well in this game because I can't fake not seeing a turtle when he's standing right next to me. But yeah, in RimWorld, it would work good. Factorio, that would work really well.
Oh, Factorio is awesome. I love watching that series.
That just came to stream, to Steam.
Did it?
Yeah.
You still have that. That was actually, people just can't watch it. That's what it is.
It's another game where people do not want to see me play it. Any of those town building games, they just do not want to see it on my channel. It never does well. Civ 5 is finally starting to die out. Nobody's watching it.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Okay, yeah, so it's just the way it is, you know? I mean, you know.
Oh, flares. Flare. Okay, we got some good shit here.
All right, let's go get the pot now.
We're going to the little campsite. All right, cool. Oh, I got the picture of this. So in case, yeah, guys, this is actually a beautiful place to build, too. It's actually the first place I ever built was over here. Biggest mistake ever. I think I stayed in my little cabin down there forever. I was so scared to come out the first time I played this game.
Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah, this game. Whew, going to the caves for the first time? Did I ever tell you what happened with my wife?
No.
Right, we're getting enough time for this story. I've been begging my wife to like make a video series with me on this game. And so I'm like, you gotta play. And she's seen it. And she's like, no effing way. I'm never playing that game. So then I started bringing it up in videos. And I started talking about it on stream. And everyone's like, come on, I want to play it. You gotta play it. And she's like, fuck you. No way. And like that. So some dude donated $200 on stream. asking her to play it.
Holy shit.
And oh, I don't see my... Yeah, there it is. All right, let's go back. And she's like, no, I'm sorry. I can't do that. And then he donated another $200 right after and said, holy please. And then I talked to her that night, and I was like, listen, that dude's really cool. He's always at the streams. I think we got to make two videos. Let's just make two videos, and, you know, that'll be it. And so she actually came on. We did it multiplayer. I played a Fat Planet. And we made two videos, and she had a great time. It was Sonic, yeah. And she had a great time. And then Sonic, while she was playing, donated another $200.
Holy shit.
To thank her. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. I'm telling you, man, like, I got the best viewers and the best stream viewers, the best YouTube video viewers. I mean, like, I did that subsistence video, and, like, I was like, you know, we're probably going to get, like, 90% people love it. And there's going to be, like, a couple people going to be like, I don't know, you know. Everybody was going nuts over it. Like,
oh, really?
I put it up today. Like, they were just gaga. They were gaga. It's a good video. It was overwhelmingly positive, which I never usually get. I was really happy about that because the developer came out and commented on it too. So I was really happy that they were all into it. So
it was it's fun. That's a beautiful game.
It is. It really is.
Got a lot of grinding on it. That's the only thing there. It's a lot of off grinding.
Well, the hardest part is before you get your base.
Yeah.
I died like 3 or 4 times before I finally got the metal pieces I needed for my base.
Those fucking bears.
Ugh.
My last episode, I killed the son of a bitch. I fucking took the...
What did you need to kill him? Like, what did you use?
That big-ass gun at the end there. Which one is it there? I think it's called. There was a big gun at the end. I ended up shooting the shit out of it. I had like 12 bullets. I think I just outlaid him on it and took out all the bullets.
So it was the rifle?
Yeah, the big rifle.
Okay, good.
The pistol doesn't do anything.
The developer told me 3 shotgun shots at close range will get him, but I don't know. It's a little closer than I'd like to be for the bear. He said the animals level up. He told me that if a bear kills you, he'll level up.
Yep. That's exactly what happens. Isn't that crazy?
Yeah. That's insane. That's how you make PvE.
Yeah, that's how you do it. That makes it even more difficult. I just want them a little more sporadic. Like this place, not have them a little more roaming.
Yeah.
That'd be cool. But hey, it's doing
they don't roam that much in my world. Like when they spawn, they stay in their area and they'll roam around their area, but they always go back to where they like kind of spawn. Like
Yeah, they have this little area where the actual box. If you haven't checked it out, check out the subsistence. It's amazing. Boy, it's amazing. I love that game.
Why don't you go ahead and make another sap collector? Because I finished yours.
Okay.
You did grab the pot, right?
Yeah, I did. Gotcha. Yeah. Go down, tree. Got to break a couple more logs. I'd like to see at least a foundation somewhat done, but we are like 121 logs away.
I'm just glad we got these lights up because those dark videos drive me nuts.
Yeah, those are horrible. But hey, at least the daytime pops in pretty quick. At least not a long overnight. So
that's true.
Okay, we'll be okay. This is part of the build. Once we start doing this part, we get this over with, which is fine. Some trees, but... I can't hear. We'll do another sap collector down here. Oh, this is a group tree. There's actually a really good cluster right here.
Somebody said to put flags by them, but I don't think we need to do that because they're going to be pretty close to our base.
Yeah, we're not going to put them too far away. There we go. Holy crap, that's a big trunk.
Where'd you put it?
I put it right beside the other one.
Okay, good.
It'd be easier. It actually lets us do it in this tree. No, it does not. Let me do it in that tree. Okay. Tree. There we go. Right this way. There we go. They're all facing towards the base. So it'll be okay. A lot easier. We'll be able to capture these. Easy to find. Anything in here? Nothing. No. The fucking trees. Have to be careful. I'm not used to trees coming down. Oh. Only when I had that dynamite.
And like, I'm not yelling out warnings. I'm just like, I hope that doesn't kill him.
Look up, asshole. Look up. There we go. All right, we're actually doing pretty good. We have someone at log sled there, too. I think we do.
There is a ton of chicory around here. I'll have to come here in my single-player world.
Yeah, I didn't realize it was this much. And it respawns, too, in single-player world, so you can actually run around in a certain area. If you do, like, a full, like, little circle, they'll come right back. There we go. Drop. But in the snowy area, nothing. It sucks, the snow area. Sucks balls. There you go.
So you, like, upset you built there, or...?
No, it's beautiful as hell. It's absolutely the most beautiful thing I've ever built, or I felt like I've ever built. The just felt nice. But the problem is just the location. It's a lot of grinding, a lot of, you know, there's no logs, and I want to keep the trees up there, so it took a lot of work. It just took a lot of work. I mean, I enjoy it. That's at the end of it, with all that work, we're going to sit back and relax. Just like when you finish yours on Goose Pond there, you're going to see it's the same thing. That finishing, but I was wondering if the update here is going to make us restart.
I haven't had to restart in a while. It's been pretty good.
I'm hoping.
You're hoping for a restart.
Well, I'm hoping to be able to finish it. I have two bases running at once, Fort Solitude and Fort Tega. They called it Fort Tega, I think. Yeah, and both of them are running at the same time, so I have to finish the other one, but I can't get it done.
All right, man, I had a timer went off, so you can take us out whenever you're ready.
Yeah, absolutely. So thank you very much, guys, for joining me. And again, make sure you guys go and check out Cage's website, his YouTube channel, very much needed. And also has a Twitch channel, very cool to watch. If you guys ever want to sit down and watch Some Days to Die and many other games he brings up, even GTA, which is really cool. So if you guys want to check it out, he's the man I go to. So it's Cage underscore, right? Underscore 848 on Twitch.
Twitch is Cage underscore 848, and yeah. And YouTube is just Cage 848.
Yep, perfect. So thank you very much for joining me. This is the Extra Game Edge.
And you gotta say this is when you say goodbye.
All right. And this is when we say goodbye, Cage.
Oh, sorry. Okay, see you later, guys.
Catch you guys on the flip side.